दोस्तों, कैसे हैं आप लोग? डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन के एमसीक्यूज लेके आई हूँ, तो इसको करते हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, चैनल्स डिस्प्ले मल्टीपाथ ड्यू टू स्कैटरिंग, टाइम डिलेड रिफ्लेक्शंस और डिफ्रेक्शन। ऑल ऑफ द मेंशन, द आंसर विल बी ऑल। चैनल्स, यू नो, चैनल आर द ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोपिगेट द सिग्नल फ्रॉम सोर्स टू द डेस्टिनेशन साइट। सो मल्टीपाथ मीन्स अ सिग्नल दैट goes through various routes in different time intervals and they reach the destinations in their own time intervals with their respective phase differences in their different path lengths. So this is multipath. So this multipath, it is due to scattering, time delayed reflections and diffraction. All the three are the reasons for it. Next is diversity technique is applied at base station, mobile receiver. No, it is applied at both base station and mobile receiver both. You know, diversity is mainly used to improve the reliability of the message signal. How much the message signal is pure? How can we recover it faithfully? What conditions must be fulfilled in a good digital communication system? High data rate, high fidelity, low transmit power. So the answer will be all. All are the conditions which should be fulfilled in any good digital communication system. The data rate should be very high. And fidelity should be high. That means as soon as the signal is being sent from the source side, the receiver should be able to recover it faithfully. The power should be transmitted low. The sampling process includes methods such as filtering, sample and hold, or amplifying. Answer will be sample and hold circuit is one of the method that the sampling process includes. Next is the limit which represents the threshold, EB by N naught, that is bit energy to noise spectral density constant. N naught is what? Bit energy to noise is spectral density constant, below which the reliable communication cannot be maintained, is called probability limit. No, error limit. No, it is called as Shannon limit. Okay, because it is the required limit below which the faithful communication cannot be achieved, the appropriate communication, the reliable communication cannot be achieved. Next is channel displays multipath due to, this is the already we have done in the first question all. Next is the reasons for the threshold effect are thermal noise, interference from other users, or the interference from circuit switching transient. See, threshold effect is what? It is due to the presence of large noise, okay, and therefore it causes loss. It causes loss in the message signal. It causes loss in message signal. So when the noise is very large, as compared to the input of the envelope detector. ED is for envelope detector. You know, this is envelope detector, RC circuit. Here the diode is connected. Here it is a source. It is used to demodulate AM signals, you know. So whenever the noise signal is very large as compared to the input at the envelope detector, the message signal gets mixed with the noise at the output. So answer will be all of the mentioned. Okay. Next is, which signaling scheme is preferred for fading channel? Fading is what? The fading is the reduction of the strength of the message signal. Okay, the amount by which it is reduced, its quality is reduced or its quality is degraded. So which signaling scheme is preferred for fading channel? FM, PM? No, it is frequency and phase based modulation. It is FM and PM. Next is, what are the design options for anti-jam communicator? It is time diversity, frequency diversity, special discrimination. All the three are the appropriate reasons for anti-jam communicator. Next is the key size of DES. See, DES is used in cryptography, so its size is around 56 bits. Next is, autocorrelation is maximum at unity, origin, true, infinite point, no, none of the mentioned, no. Next is, as the number of carriers increases, the capacity of transponder, it decreases. Okay, sorry, so the B will be the right option. Increase तो नहीं होता है, remains the same भी नहीं होता है. If the number of carriers increases, the capacity of the transponder decreases. Next is, stochastic processes are random in nature, are function of time. It is random in nature and are a function of time. Okay. Next question, let us see. Which is a quantization error? See, what is a quantization error? You know, quantization is what? It is discretization of along the y-axis, that is along x-axis and along the y-axis both. So is it rounding, और इट इज ट्रंकेशन और इट इज वॉट बोथ और वॉट इट इज. सो वॉट इज अ क्वांटाइजेशन प्रोसेस? इट इज राउंडिंग एंड ट्रंकेशन बोथ. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट इज टाइमिंग जिटर. टाइमिंग जिटर कैन बी रिड्यूस्ड बाय गुड पावर सप्लाई आइसोलेशन नो, स्टेबल क्लॉक रेफरेंस नो. इट इज रिड्यूस्ड बाय बोथ गुड पावर सप्लाई आइसोलेशन. देयर शुड बी एज मच एज द आइसोलेशन ऑफ एनी गुड पावर सप्लाई एंड द स्टेबल क्लॉक रेफरेंस. द प्रॉपर क्लॉक फैसिलिटी शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड सो दैट इट द सिंक्रोनाइजेशन इज इजिली अचीव्ड. ओके नेक्स्ट इज द आउटपुट ऑफ सोर्स इनकोडर इज एन एनालॉग सिग्नल. आई डोंट थिंक सो. इट इज नॉट ट्रू. इट इज फॉल्स बिकॉज द आउटपुट ऑफ सोर्स इनकोडर इट इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ द बाइनरी डिजिट्स ना with less redundancy. It is used in the digital communication system. It is a sequence of the binary digits. It is used to compress the signal coming from the input. The output of any information source is random in nature, but the output of source encoder is a sequence of binary digits, and binary digits is itself a digital in nature. Next is, in which mixing is easier? Analog, digital, analog and digital. In analog, the mixing is easier. I think so. If you have any queries, you can write down to me in comment section also, because analog signal has only one control. But the digital signal, there occurs some confusion also. There are many signal controls. There is one automatic control in the analog signal. So analog signal mein mixing is easier. Next is which requires bit transitions. Asynchronous, synchronous, asynchronous and synchronous. Bit transitions is required in synchronous transmission because it is continuous in nature. Okay? And while the asynchronous transmission is sporadic in nature. It is sporadic in nature. Next is channel can provide connectivity, you know, if there is a channel. You have already read in FDM, TDM, in multiple access techniques, in point to point or multi-point. Channel can provide connectivity to all of these, point to point, one to many, many to many, okay. Next is atmospheric window region is used for satellite communication, no. Deep space communication, no. Satellite and deep space communication, true. So answer will be satellite and deep space communication. If you like the questions, kindly like, share and subscribe, okay. Till then. I can say good morning. Oh, sorry.